Welcome to the FCC's online tutorial on the Federal Register Summary System, or FRS. FRS is an automated SGML tagging system that streamlines the process of publishing summary documents in the Federal Register. First, let's discuss why we created FRS. The FCC, like all other federal agencies, publishes a voluminous quantity of official notifications. The Government Printing Office gives a 35% discount for documents that are provided in the approved SGML tagged format over documents provided in paper, and close to a 30% discount for documents provided in Word format. This gave the FCC a powerful incentive to devise an automated tagging system. Next, let's look at how we went about creating the FRS. For our first group of documents, we selected those that are most formulaic with individual identifying information embedded in that boilerplate. We deconstructed those documents according to the Federal Register practice into their component parts to create a library of document components. Then we tagged those components to conform to the Federal Register publication requirements. In FRS, when the author selects a particular document type, the system calls the relevant document components and creates a template. The author is then able to fill in the variables such as date, comment period, name, call sign, and location. We designed FRS to then create a review copy in Word. For OS users who have MicroComp installed, the Word Review button also generates the three-column format used by GPO. When the author completes his or her part and submits it, the system sends email notification to the next person to review or complete the next part of the project. The progress of the document is tracked automatically and creates management information that can be checked on an ad hoc basis or issued as regular reports. Finally, let's take a look at the actual FRS system. To create a new Federal Register summary, click on New FR from the navigation menu. The New FR screen will be displayed. Then, from the Document Number Type dropdown, select a document number type. Next, enter a document number in the Document Number field. Next, select an FR type from the dropdown menu. Then select an FR document type from the dropdown menu. Click OK to continue to the FR Summary and Tracking screen. When Summary and Tracking screen is displayed, it is populated with a template based on the selections from the previous screen. To edit, click on the field you wish to edit. Information in brackets should be edited. The Summary and Supplementary information uses MS Word to edit the field. When the field is clicked once, it will display MS Word with the template embedded in the document. When editing is done, close out the MS Word without saving. When MS Word is exited, the edited information is captured in the field. The following action buttons are available at the bottom of the form. Save will save changes you have made. Word Review will generate an MS Word document with the full contents of the summary for the purpose of reviewing only. For OS users who have MicroComp installed, the Word Review button also generates the three-column format used by GPO. Send to Liaison will route the record to the designated Bureau Liaison for review. This button can change depending on the status of the FR record. Close will close the record. Then select a Bureau Liaison from the Tracking tab. The date fields in the FR Tracking tab are automatically updated as the record goes through the approval process. Finally, select Action from the menu bar and select Send to Liaison. The record will be routed to the Bureau or Office Liaison. For each routing function, FRS automatically sends an email to the routing target. FR summaries that are not being SGML tagged to conform to the Federal Register publication can still be routed through FRS and e-signed using the freeform. To create a freeform summary, click on New FR from the navigation menu. The New FR screen will be displayed. Then, from the Document Number Type dropdown, select the document number type. Enter a document number in the Document Number field. Then, select FR Type from the dropdown menu. Next, select Freeform from the FR Document Type drop-down menu, then click OK. The FR Summary tab will be displayed. Next, click on the Summary field. This action will launch a blank MS Word document for the authors to populate. When MS Word is closed out, all the data is captured in the Summary field. Finally, the author is finished with the summary. They can route the summary to the next stage of the approval process. The signatory can sign the summary by clicking on the Sign button. If Intrust, which is a digital certificate software, is not logged on to the Intrust server at GPO, when the Sign button is clicked, the Intrust login screen will pop up. The signatory can type in their Intrust password and click OK. When the signing operation is completed, FRS will display a message confirming that the FRS summary is signed. After the summary is signed, the record is routed to OSAPG for forwarding to the Government Imprinting Office. The designated APG staff member will access the signed record and click on the Send to OFR button. This action will trigger an email to submittedfedreg@fedreg.gov with the signed FR summary as an attachment. Everyone that was involved in the process is CC'd on the email. Thank you for watching this tutorial on the FCC's Federal Register Summary System. For questions or comments, please contact Cheryl Siegel at cheryl.siegel@fcc.gov.